originat thought. Of course, derived from original, not, and thought is meaning an idea or creation that you came up with that actually was already thought of by someone else. So something you believed was an original thought that someone actually got to first. And since I'm changing English every single day, talking about so many different topics, I'm sure a lot of the ideas that I will end up portraying aren't gonna be entirely original all the time. I don't think I've done a whole lot where that's been the case. And when my idea is directly sourced from someone else, and I'm sure that that's the case, I've been pretty good with giving credit to those people when I'm aware of the source. But going through this journey, I'm sure that there's gonna be a couple things where, like, I talk about an idea for a long time, or I think that I came up with it, when realistically, there's already people who have gone through it at length. And originat thoughts can come up from a couple different ways. I mean, sometimes you come up with something that you think is completely original and you had no outside inspiration or things pushing you to that idea. You just came up with it on your own. Problem was, someone else already beat you to it. But sometimes you actually were exposed to the source of the idea, and maybe it's just been like a couple years and you end up forgetting that you learned an idea from someone and that it's not your own, but you just kind of come across it and think of it and you forget where it came from. So that's a possibility as well. So I wanted to get this creation out there just in case I have some originat thoughts. We can just call it out and be aware that, oh, actually this guy covered this a while ago. That might be where you got the idea. Or you can just call out that, like, there's a more comprehensive version of that idea over here doing something like that. It's good to try to give people credit when they have thought of something, but I'm not here to be the idea police. If an idea is good, it's good and worth sharing. The first person to ever think of something shouldn't be the only one talking about whatever idea they came up with. It's good to pay respect to that person. However, if your idea is genuinely good, you want to spread that and have it be more widely beneficial to people. So one of the things I try to do on my channel is to just put out great ideas or show things that are awesome, even if it isn't me, because I feel like they should be spotlighted, even if it's not directly sourced from old Whippy Thoughts here. But that's what we got for the creation for today. Don't be afraid to share your thoughts if they are something you believe in, just because someone else has already said them. And a lot of the times, even if you do think you're sharing something original, it could just not be too. So don't be afraid to just say what you believe, because it's hard to be original, especially in today's world. Because at this point, humans have been around for a long time, and we are way better at communicating and sharing ideas than we have ever been and helping build on them. So it's the most difficult time to be original, probably in history, and that will likely continue. At least purely original from that stance. But, like, you can still build on things that have already been there, and that's one of the best ways to use creativity and continue thinking now. Well, that's what we got. Let's move on to our song and video of the day. I'm pretty excited about this song of the day. It is Future Kids of America by Derek Pope. I just discovered Derek Pope yesterday and was blown away by his music. It was really awesome. I've listened to a little over 2 full albums at this point from him and was very impressed. He's got a sound actually kind of similar to Kid Cudi, which I don't say that about many people at all. I think part of that is that his voice and delivery is actually fairly similar, but he's got an interesting style that I very much enjoy, and I'm excited to look more into Derek Pope because he seems like an awesome artist. Then for the video of the day, it is the plane bathroom scene from Get Smart. I hadn't seen this movie in like 10 years maybe, and it used to be one of my favorites, and this scene always just cracks me up. It is so good. And seeing Steve Carell choose to use a crossbow to try to undo his binds over anything else in his agent-issued Swiss Army knife, it's just so funny. And I really love this scene. It's definitely worth watching. Really like the movie too. It was great seeing that again. And yeah, like that. Anyway, that'll do it for the Daily Do. Peace out.